one, brothers and sisters. Once again, it's the voice of Brother Tanza Duck, coming at you through the Spirit of the Most High in Christ. I'm going to continue talking on about walking in the Spirit, because many of you are walking on a physical plane, the plane of beast and appetite. So, I'm going to continue on. I was addressing the sisters, and I know many of you, before you switch off this channel, I click off, don't try to receive this on an emotional level. Receive it from the Spirit of which I'm giving it. So many sisters would say, you can't tell me nothing. I do what I want to do. And that's what they were saying during the time of Jeremiah. Fulfilling the scriptures again. The book of Jeremiah 44 and 16. And he was trying to correct them. And they said, as for the word that thou hast spoken unto us in the name of the Lord, because that's how we're coming through you. That's how we're coming at you, through the Spirit of Yahweh Bahasham Yahweh Shah. We will not hearken unto thee, verse 17, but we will certainly do whatsoever thing goeth forth from our own mouth. My precious sisters, do not walk after the lust of the flesh. Romans 9 and 4. The righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. You must put off the old woman and walk in the Spirit of truth. Book of Romans 8 verse 8 says, so then, they that are in the flesh cannot please God. Romans 8 and 13 says, for if ye live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye live through the Spirit, do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. The book of Galatians 5 and 16 says it like this. I say then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. So you might say, Tazadak, Doc, you ain't so righteous. I bet if we examine your life and look at you, you sin too. Brothers and sisters, all have sinned and come short to the glory of God. I didn't come down from heaven. I came up from hell. You see, I speak to you. I don't speak to you as a man that I once was. I speak to you as a man walking in the light. The light emulates from me. Those spirits that want you to continue to walk in darkness does not want the true light to come to you. If you wish to continue to walk in spiritual darkness, you will not receive this message, but you will retract it. So the scriptures read in the book of John 1 and 5, and the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. Brothers and sisters, accept the Mashiach as your Savior, repent, and amend your doings. In the book of Isaiah 60 verse 1, it says, arise and shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. One of the first things that our Lord Yahushua, Yeshua, said when he began to teach was repent. Repent. Because he was sent to die for our sins. Thus, we must repent and sin no more. Matthew 4 and 17. From that time, Yeshua began to preach and say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Acts 3 and 19 says, repent ye therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. Sisters, the Lord is requiring you to come out of this world. He means not to imitate the lifestyles and sexual wickedness of this world. You cannot serve God and the devices of Satan. This world is not of God. You can go to church every Sunday, but you're not praising the Most High. You're not praising God. You're not praising the God of the Bible, because he gives specific orders on which day we should worship. He says 6 days shall I work. On the seventh day? It's a Sabbath. The black preachers have you going to church, worshiping on a Sunday. Justify that with the Bible. The black preachers have you serving the wrong God. You must return to the one God. Why must you not follow this world, brothers and sisters? Because this world is being ruled by Satan. This world is under Satan's authority. USA under Satan's authority. This is a corporate fiction. It's a corporation. John 4:13. This is what the Mashiach had to say. The book of John 4:30. Hereafter, I will not talk much with you, for the prince of this world cometh and have nothing in me. Who's the prince of this world? Satan. Who's this world being controlled by? Satan. If someone is sitting in the president's seat, who are they controlled by? Satan. For the prince of this world cometh and have nothing in me. So, Christ warned you. Christ warned you. And the beauty of it all, sisters and brothers, is that if you follow the truth, the Most High has chosen you over others in this world. Book of John 15:16. Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that ye shall go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit shall remain, that whosoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it you. So if you start to lose friends, brothers and sisters, and people begin not to talk to you, don't become discouraged. You're better off without those type of people pulling you down anyways. Some will even dislike or hate you just because you decide to live right. But they don't really hate you. They hate the Mashiach. They hate Yeshua. They hate Christ. John 7:7. The world cannot hate you, but me hate it, because I testify of it, that the works thereof of evil. That's why they don't like me. Sisters, repent. Repent. And represent the beautiful women of the Most High that you were meant to be. God did not make strippers. He didn't make sluts. He did not make a bitch. He did not make a hooker. A woman that sleeps with multiple men and consider that liberation. God did not make that. God made a virtuous woman. And you must return to that which you really are, not what the world has molded you into. Now let me speak to the brothers. Now, since we as men are supposed to be the headship or the cornerstones and the guidance for our beautiful queens and children, it's no wonder that they are misguided. How Satan has provided guidance to the sheep of the Most High. We men are swimming within a sex pool of ignorance and lust. Brothers, we got to talk. Many of you are not going to like me for this, but oh well, that's emotional. You'll get past that. We men are swimming within a sex pool of ignorance and lust. Many of us are possessed with demons. We live on a carnal level. We use any device possible to seduce women. We promise them the world, but what we don't tell them is that it's a world of sin, hurt, lies, humiliation, heartbreak, cheating, and abuse, be it physically or mentally. Y'all, I'm going to talk to you, brothers. We abandon our children. We leave her alone with our children. And we run out. And we start a family with another one. You say, man, I got this bad sister. I'm blazing her every night. And she just loves me to death. And that's about the size of it, brother. That's about the size of it. See, a good woman, she will scold you when you're going wrong. But you flee from that. Because you don't want that. You want to take the path of the lesser resistance. And when you abort the path of existence, brothers, you stop yourself from developing into the true man of the Heavenly Father that you're intended to be. You said, what are you talking about, Tata? Well, let me explain it to you. When we are supposed to be challenged. When we suppress our challenge and turn away from struggle, brothers, we stunt our growth and development of character. The process of growth always attained with pain. The process of evolution and growth always attained with pain. I'm going to say that again, brothers. The process of evolution and growth always attained with pain. I said pain. Why would I want to experience pain, Tyler, Doc? Well, I'm going to prove my point. Yet, if you stand and endure the chastisement, endure the struggle, we come out stronger. But instead, when things get a little difficult, we'll abandon our women and children as a bunch of cowards by running away with our tails between our legs. We must learn to deal with her from the head up instead of just from the neck down. You understand what I'm saying? We must learn to deal with her, brother, on a spiritual realm. We always want to deal with her from the neck down. We never want to deal with her from the neck up. So, brothers, we need a checkup from the neck up. What I mean is we are really sick men. We measure our manhood by how many women that we can have sex with us, with many of us. How much money we have in our pockets, that fiat currency, or 22-inch chrome rims, you simple, complacent Negroes. Oh, I'm riding 20s. Oh, I got 24s. Grown men walking around with the pants pulled down, hanging beloved buttocks. Same. Sick. A sickened society. Brother, we have failed as men. We fell. We fell to be an example. You gotta be careful in how you operate in this society. So, brothers, what I mean when I say it's the process of evolution and growth attains with pain from the very beginning. When you are born into this world and you come through the vicissitudes of life, when the baby goes through the birth canal, it's a painful process for both the mother and the baby. So from the beginning, we see that it's a difficult process and we can't abort the path of difficulty. Because thereafter comes your reward. When the baby is born, it comes out. The baby cries. The mom's in labor pain. The baby cries. Ah! What you crying for? I'm hearing that it was a painful journey. The mother goes through excruciating pain because the process of evolution and growth attains with pain. We see that from the beginning. When we abort that path for the path of the lesser resistance, we stop developing the more character in us in which the Most High intended. The process of evolution and growth always attends with pain. Shalom.